فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters, I'm in Liberia. People ask a question often. You've been to so many countries. Which is your favorite country? And I must tell you that I've come to realize that every country is my favorite, but from a different angle, from a different aspect. All the countries are absolutely beautiful, but what happens is we tend to grade a country based on certain things, whereas the Almighty has bestowed blessings upon every nation at times in a different way. So what we need to realize is there is no specific place that we can actually say this is the favorite, and then it makes it look like the rest are not our favorite or they're not good. I really love all the countries I've been to, and I really think that each one has its own speciality. Each one has something unique about it. The country you call home is a beautiful country, I guess. From a spiritual aspect, Mecca and Medina are my favorite cities. But when it comes to the presence of my family and so on, what I call home or the place I call home is my favorite, definitely. Zimbabwe is my home, so I definitely consider it my favorite place. But I'd like to ask the Almighty, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease, goodness, and may we be from among those who appreciate one another. We should be appreciating all countries. We should be appreciating all the people as well, because people from the north are different from people of the south. Not because we should be hating on each other, but there is a speciality that each one has, something unique. And this is why those who say you cannot marry someone from the south or the north if you come from the opposite, they are wrong. You can actually marry them. The reason why the Almighty has made us different is not so that we can become racist or we can become people who hate on others, but it is only in order to recognize one another. When you recognize one another, you appreciate the diversity that you have. Imagine if everyone looked like you. Every single person on earth looked exactly like you. Copy. The Almighty says every nation is different because we have made you different, so you recognize one another. Now, if you look at your thumbprint, you look at your iris, you know, the scan of the iris, absolutely different. Every single human being from the beginning right up to this day and right up to the end shall be very, very different. Now, going back to this beautiful country, Liberia, I was told today that Liberia was the breadbasket of West Africa, mashallah. It was a nation where all the airlines used to come, everything used to happen here, and it used to be a really, really great country until war broke out here in 1990. And I want to pause for a moment. The lesson I have is, brothers and sisters, war brings about nothing but destruction. There is no reason for people to kill each other. No matter what problems you have, there is a way of resolving it as human beings. Do not let anything destroy the peace, stability, security that you enjoy. Remember that message. It's a very strong message. There are people who are spreading hate in so many countries across the globe right now as we speak. We will continue spreading a message of love, goodness, peace, respect, and understanding among people of all faiths, all races, all nationalities. We need to understand when you have differences and disagreements, the way to deal with these differences and disagreements is not through violence. It's not through becoming vulgar and abusive, but rather maintain a very high level of values, morals, even of language. And remember to be calm. Remember, your temperament is something that would actually control you at a certain stage to the degree that you may regret. So therefore, just be very patient. Be from among those who thinks before he or she does anything, and don't ever let the gifts of the Almighty slip through your fingers. Remember, we have Iman, we have faith in the Almighty, and then we have aman, we have peace, we have stability, security. These are favors of the Almighty. I'd rather have a nation or be in a country where we might be slightly poor, but we have stability, security, we're safe, than to be in a country that's wealthy, but you don't even know if you're going to live for the next 5 minutes, not based on the power of the Almighty, which is always there, but based on the fact that people are so violent and there is war and it's so unsafe. I'd rather be in a country that is safer with a little bit less than to be in a country that is totally unsafe with much more. So remember, that goes to show the gift of safety that the Almighty bestows upon us. It's up to us to ensure that we repeat this message so that people understand and realize the value of this great gift of the Almighty. So my brothers and sisters, I hope you benefited from that beautiful message. Like I said, Liberia is going back to the days of glory that it had before, and it's growing by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We pray not only for Liberia, but for all other countries. May the Almighty help us prosper, and may we understand that it is only when we have peace and goodness that we will be able to prosper in every way. The ultimate peace is that in the heart and the mind. The ultimate peace is that with the Almighty. That is the ultimate peace, because we do know that when you get closer to your Maker, you achieve the inner peace as well. And that is primary. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you for listening to this beautiful message. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.